Christmas. I want to welcome everyone again to today's Eucharistic celebration. Today is familiar, in fact, today Christ the Light has come. And I want to welcome all the visitors in our church today. People coming to celebrate together with their families that have deemed it wise to come to the church to praise God for Christmas celebration today. This is the day that we all have been waiting for the past 4 weeks. We have been praying and anticipating this wonderful day. And so we gather today to celebrate the nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus, the gift from God to the world to save us from sin and eternal damnation. This day is a day of glory, a day of praise, a day of celebration, a day of when people that walk in darkness saw the true light of God. A day when our Savior, our King, our Healer, our Alpha and Omega was born. Today's first reading re-emphasizes this by saying, how beautiful upon the mountains at the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace and bringing the good news to everyone. The presence of Jesus Christ brings glad tidings. The presence of Jesus Christ brings peace, love, and unity. The gospel of today will express the true meaning of Christmas and a great gift coming from God to the entire humanity. The gospel says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh. You remember when Archangel Gabriel came to Mary and said, Mary, you will bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus, Emmanuel, meaning God is with us, meaning the Messiah, the Healer, the Protector, the Provider, the Omega. Jesus Christ is the true light, the true gift that came from God. The Word became flesh. And so, friends, as we celebrate this Christmas, I would like for us to take home 3 points. Number one, thank you. I want to thank each and every one of you for the progress you have made towards the growth of our church this year. Many of us consecrated ourselves to Jesus Christ through Mary. Some of us went to the diocese. And we pass through the Holy Law in the year of mercy. We represented our parish. I want to thank all the organizations in this parish, all the ministers, the pastoral care team, the social activities team, the spiritual growth team. I want to thank our staff and our deacon and the choir. It takes a teamwork to make a dream work. We all have worked hard for the success of this great parish. Thanks to all of you. May God continue to bless you. Number two, enjoy your family. Christmas has a way of bringing to church individuals and families who, for various reasons, have not been to Mass for months or years. And we are so happy to see many faces in our church. Last night, the church was full, the chapel was full, the narthex. So many good faces. People coming from different places, different states to celebrate with their family. That is the spirit of Christmas, the spirit of unity. I was telling them last night that the culture here in the U.S. is not the culture in Nigeria. Because one could be born in Michigan and a person gets married in New York and gets a job in Texas and permanently lives in Pennsylvania. So wherever you are, it's your own home. But in our own culture, if you are born in Michigan, even if you get your job in Pennsylvania or in Ohio, during Christmas, you must come home. You are coming back to Michigan. And so Christmas reminds me again and again the importance of the family. Because at Christmas time, everyone in Nigeria who lives in a big city and they come home to celebrate their families. Even shops are locked until New Year because everyone is coming home. No more business. Come home and celebrate with your family. Come and reunite with your family. So it is always a very important thing to see people coming together and to celebrate today. Maybe you got most of the things that you wanted this year. Or maybe you did not. In any case, celebrate with your family. Maybe your dreams and goals came through this year. Or maybe not. In any case, celebrate with your family. Last week I was writing the Christmas message that went into the bulletin. And I was taking a look on the statistics of what we have done this year. And I realized that 19 parishioners that started the year with us could not end the year with us. 19 parishioners. Even last week, 2 people died. Louis, Jesse, and James Kosenjo. We had a funeral mass for Louis on Friday. And James was here in this church last Sunday. He came to mass. I shook his hand. I blessed him. And I told him that I'm still praying for his brother. Because we had a memorial service for his brother that passed away. It was this September. There was nothing wrong. As a matter of fact, his father got a call. They went to bed, there was no problem. So in the morning, he couldn't wake up. So the phone rang, and then he went to James' room to wake him up to answer the call. James was gone. James was gone. This life comes so briefly. It comes and goes so quickly. And that is the reason why each day counts as a blessing. Love your family. Love your wife.
Love your husband. Love your children. Love your parents. Love your grandparents. The people that you see today, time is coming when you no longer see them. Be kind to your grandparents. Even when they say the things you don't like, be patient with them. You will never realize the importance of what you have until when you lose it. Family counts a lot to me. And that's the reason why every year I go home to reconnect with my family. We celebrate Mass. We invite our friends. We thank God for the year and pray for the next year. Yesterday, I even called my mom to wish her a happy Christmas. And I bought live chicken for her for the Christmas. And rice. I called my brothers. I called my sisters as well. I called some of them. If I don't call them, they will call me, and they will call me at 1 a.m. So when they were happy, and I told them, even though I wasn't there physically with them, I'm there spiritually celebrating Christmas. Family is very, very important. This morning also I called my mom and said, Happy Christmas. I appreciate the people in your life. And so as we gather together today to celebrate as a family, make the best use of this Christmas. Count this Christmas as the best one. If there's anything between you and your son, between you and your daughter, between you and your siblings, get it settled. Let all those things go with this year. Begin a new slate. Next year. Create that peaceful mind within yourself. And allow that peace, love, and unity that come with Christmas to stay with you. Number three, take Jesus home with you. God gave us His Son as a gift. Let us take Jesus Christ to all the people that we meet. Christ is the true light. And may that light continue to shine through us, through the things that we do. And some of the examples that we can take the light to the world are these. A. Pray for those that have lost their beloved ones this year. You never know the importance of what you have to when you lose it. Some parishioners, some friends have lost their beloved ones this year. Pray for those people. It's always a tough time during festivities when the family is not that complete. Pray for these people. Give them phone call. Call them and say, you know, we're praying for you. We are with you. Send them cards. B. Leave a kind note and gift for your mailman in your mailbox. Leave a kind note and gift for your mailman in your mailbox. These men and women provide wonderful services to all of us, regardless of the weather, snow, rain, traffic. They are always there. Just tell them, thank you. Give them a little gift. Appreciate what they do. There are ways we can share the light to the world. C. Visit the hospital at homebound and spend time with those that are not celebrating their family this Christmas. Sometimes it's tough. Some people don't even remember that today is Christmas Day. Some people are in pain. Some people can't even eat. Within this Christmas season, Spend a little time with them. Visit them. Give them a pat on the back. That will mean a lot in their lives. D. Be kind to someone you dislike and forgive those that have offended you. Be kind to someone you dislike and forgive those that have offended you. Forgiveness is the bridge that we all must pass through if we must go to heaven. And so the spirit of Christmas is the spirit of love, spirit of unity, spirit of forgiveness. Think of all those people that have hurt in your life. Those that you have vowed never to forgive. Forgive them. And you see the light of God shining through you again. And when you forgive, you liberate yourself. When you forgive, you create a peaceful mind within yourself. So, this Christmas time, make it a point of duty to forgive those that have offended you. Finally, my Lord Jesus Christ, born in Bethlehem, bless you, bless your family, bless your beloved ones as you gather to celebrate this Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry.